There's a sefer that's called Olam HaMidot regarding a person working on his midot. This might be maybe one or two parts, but it is a very, very important sefer. And over here he explains, it brings down the Gaon Mevilna, what is the whole purpose that we come to this world? Correct? We want to serve Hashem, we want to do mitzvot, we want to learn Torah Rabotai, but with all this, what is the whole tafkid? What is the whole purpose of doing all this? I just want to read for you, right in the beginning of the sefer, he brings down over here in Olam HaMidot. The Gaon Mevilna says, Amishle Perek Dal Pasuk Yud Gimel, Ki Masha Adam Chai, this that a person lives in this world, Hu Kedei Lishbor Masha Lo Shabar Ad Hena Ota Midah. That's in order for you to be able to break your midot, what you weren't able to break up to now. Lachen, therefore he says, Tzarich Tamid Litchazek, therefore a person needs to always strengthen himself. Listen carefully. The Gaon Mevilna says, if a person is not going to strengthen in bettering himself as a person, in his character traits, so what is the whole purpose of him having life? Rabotai, I went to shul, to daven mincha. I'm not going to say when. I parked my car properly, Ken. There were a few cars that they double parked. Rabotai, they blocked, I couldn't come out. I had to wait for them. So they think it's okay. Rabotai, people, when I tell you, I don't want to say what kind of people they were. They were not for sure chilonim. They were religious people, Rabotai. And they tell me, wait, please, I have to come out, let me finish this. But I have to go. And plus, you're doing chil Hashem by double parking, Rabotai. You coming to do a mitzvah derabanan, where you're holding back other people. I'm a Jew. But what happens if there's going also parked on the side, and they and I have to go, and you're doing chil Hashem, which is the right, which is karet ul naraton. So what do we think we're accomplishing? We're going inside, and then they tell me, wait a few minutes, let me move my car, Rabotai. If these type of people, Rabotai, they learn Torah and they do everything, where are the midot, Rabotai? This is what I want to try to bring out today. We can do everything, but if we do not have midot, Rabotai, we have nothing. That's what Chazal tell us. A person who does not have Yerushamayim, you should know that he also has no Torah. He's no worse than a donkey that's only carrying books. Just like a donkey carries books, so too he's like that, Rabotai. We have to try to be different than donkeys. That's why we have to try to perfect ourselves. With that in mind, he says over here, Avodat Tikkun HaMidot. Before I begin to read, Rabotai, I want to explain to you something. One of the biggest problems we have today, we listen to a lot of people. But one of the biggest mistakes we do is we start applying everything people say, not knowing is what they say fits us or not. You go to a clothing shop, you have triple extra large, correct? Tell me you're going to buy the suit? No, that you're not going to buy. So why whenever you attend the shul, you hear something, oh, that's it, I'm going to do this now. Or I'm not going to do it. Rabotai, you have to understand. You cannot start applying things to just because you heard it. You got to know yourself. You got to speak to your local rabbi that knows you very well. Are you ready to move up that level in Avodat Hashem? People take everything, all the chumrot, Rabotai. I know people, all the stringencies before you know it, Rabotai. Unfortunately, a lot of them, Rabotai, fall off eventually because they didn't know the basic definition of halakha. In any event, Rabotai, I wanted to try to show you over here that everybody has different character traits. Everybody has a different purpose in this world. What's good for me might not be good for you. What's good for you might not be good for me. You have to see what fits you. Size 40 might fit you. Size 46 is not going to fit you. This is what he wants to bring down over here. Avodat tikkun HaMidot. Umahi avodat tikkun HaMidot. Rabotai, what is this fixing your character trait? What is it? Katav HaRambam. The Rambam writes, Halachot de'ot perek alf halach alef. De'ot arbe yesh lechol echad ve'echad bebri adam. People have many tendencies. Each one is different than the other. Each one is even distant than the other. Everybody has different tendencies. You have a person who gets angered very easily. He's very hot-tempered. You have a person that his mind always at ease. He'll never get angry. And if he does get angry, that one time he gets angry, it's going to happen after many years. It's a different type of people. You have a person who's very haughty. You have a person who's very humble. You have different types of people. You have a person that he'll never be satiated from this world. No matter how much he pumps all the garbage into his body, He'll never be satiated. That's the type of person he is. But you have a person who's very pure. He's not going to even go after things that he needs. He does. He just doesn't need it. You have such people. You have a person that is being, no matter how much money he's going to make, he'll never be satiated. Give him a million, not enough. 2 million, 10 million, 10 billion. He's never satiated about this type of people. A person who loves money, he'll never be satiated with money. Never. That's what Rabotai, they say when a person dies, he doesn't die with half of what he was supposed to accomplish. Why? Because by the time you reach 30, 40, 50, you accumulated 10 million, let's say for example. Now that's only half because now you want 20 million. So no matter how much you have, you're always dying with half of what you wanted to accumulate. Rabotai, you have a person that he restrains himself. He only goes after what's mamish nesa, even that. He'll try to not get it. V'yeshu masgev atzmo bir'av. Rabotai, lo leinu, Rabotai, how many times we see this? Guys, when I'm reading this midot, you have to understand how many of us fall under these categories. We have to try to see this. You have people, Rabotai, how many times women come? And they tell me, Rabbi, huh, what happened? My husband donates money. What did he donate? To shul. Okay, I don't know the people personally. Do what they say, Rabotai. How much? To what? 10,000, 5,000, 15,000? What's the problem? Good for him. Now you don't understand. He doesn't give me a dollar. He doesn't give me nothing. Outside, he's the king. Over inside the house, I'm like a slave to him. Rabotai, sach. Yes, amen. You got it. Yeah. V'yesh, Rabotai, listen to this. Look at amen. This is. V'yesh, you must give atzmo b'ra'av. Rabotai, you have a person who's going to torture himself with famine. V'kivetz al yodo, he's going to tighten his fist. He's not going to eat one penny of his. That's how sach he is. Only if it's great pain, only then he's going to spend a dollar. You have a person that could lose all his money knowingly. Rabotai, he continues, he says, Rabotai, in this type of way, you have all other types of tendencies. You have an optimist, you have a pessimist. You have a miser, you have a wealthy person who always gives. You have somebody who's cruel, somebody who's mercy. You have somebody who's weak of heart, you have somebody who's strong of heart, fearless. Rabotai, and you have similar things. Give me 2 minutes, I'm only just going to conclude this. It's very important. Rabotai, we see all these tendencies, each one is different than the other. Not every person is different than the other. But listen to what he says over here. Ulechen, therefore, lechol echad yesh nisyonot miyuchadim bidarko. Everybody has special tests in which have come his way. Lahasagat ashalimut, to be able to reach the complete true avodot in the character traits. Ulechol echad yesh mahalach mishilo. Ech litgaber al nisyonotav. Rabotai, each one has his own way, has able to go ahead and overpower his character, bad character traits. But our purpose, everyone is the same thing, Rabotai, and this is it. Rabotai, a person has to work on himself in this world until his midot are perfect. I'm telling you right now, Rabotai, if a person right now goes ahead and he shackles, correct, Dum Shum Esrei, and he makes noise and he starts clapping, if in the shul they don't clap, I know certain shuls they do clap. If everybody does, it's one thing. But now you come and you start clapping, and you ask, oh, Tate! In the Dum Shum Esrei, Rabotai, what kind of midot is it, Rabotai? Everybody, you just made Brach Levatai because now nobody remembers where they are holding. Rabotai, we have to be able to take everything in proportion. Rabotai, we will continue. It's very important at Sefer.